Well, first of all, we all have hair and we all have been styling it. What we found though is us with curly, coily, and textured hair have often had a difficult time distinguishing which products are best for it. So we thought, let's use science to better understand and characterize the nuances of our hair so we can then better choose products for the future.
Hello, I'm Sophie Robner from the American Chemical Society. Welcome to this media briefing from ACS Spring 2023. Black women and others with curly or kinky hair encounter a vast and confusing array of hair care options. Advice on the best products to use for a certain type of hair is often contradictory, and the results can be highly variable. Now, scientists are bringing order to this chaos by identifying properties such as the number of curls or coils in a given length of hair that could eventually help users pick the perfect product and achieve consistent results. To tell us more, we're joined today by Professor Michelle Gaines and undergraduate Imani Page from Spelman College. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having us.
Michelle and Imani, where did you get the idea to do this project?
This idea has been brewing in my mind for many years, all through my postdocs, I would say a little of graduate school, and definitely once I got to Spelman College. And I mentioned it to my classes and my students many times, and have gotten a lot of interest from them as well in wanting to work on the project. And so when we started to dive into the history of the literature on this topic, we found that there were a lot of gaps. And so we found that we could start answering those and filling those.
How did you investigate this?
I was fortunate enough to be doing a lot of investigation for this experiment and for this paper. The main things that we focused on were the mechanical and physical properties of the hair. We looked at how many curls was on a given length of hair. We chose 3 centimeters just because it was a very consistent amount. And we would just look at how many times the hair tended to fold over itself or curl over itself. We also looked at the hair at its fracture point to see which type of hair would fracture or would be able to resist fracturing for the longest. And then we were able to look at it under different types of microscopy to look at the porosity of the hair and to look at just the more smaller bits of hair, like the cuticle sheathing on it.
What did you find out?
From this research, we were able to find out that using the most visible parts of the hair and using our 3 centimeters length of hair, we could see the number of contours or the number of curls in the hair, and we could create a new classification system based off of that. For example, in our straightest hair types, you see almost 0 curls in it, but in our most curly hair types, you can see upwards of 5 curls in it, and using these numbers along with the numbers of the lengths of the curls, or how long they measured, we were able to create a new system that we can use to better classify all the different hair types that we see in our everyday life.
And what are the implications of these findings?
So the implications would be using this information to further build on the story for how curly, coil, and textured hair behave on a natural in its natural form. And then also to learn more about, because right now the results that we're showing are all related to dry samples of hair that have not been exposed to anything, including water. So the implications would be then to understand further how perturbations basically would affect our hair in its natural state.
So perturbations meaning?
Adding things that would change it from its natural state, as simple as combing, as simple as adding water, adding any type of product or anything like that.
What will you do next?
So one area that we're targeting is understanding the surface of our hair. So with respect to how the cuticles look on the surface. So what those are basically coverings that line up across our hair or down our hair fiber. And they open and close, kind of like roof shingles. And we're looking at how easy or difficult it is depending on the morphology or the structure of a piece of hair. And that will tell us also how well water can get in and out. And then also sometimes about how certain products behave because they have a certain pH that are associated with it. So understanding also how the surface charge on the surface of each of our hair strands contribute to that opening and closing of the shingles.
I understand you also studied something called the uncurling force. What can you tell me about that?
So the uncurling force is the force that's involved that holds the curl shape in curly hair and in coily textured and kinky hair. And that's what gives it its natural look or appearance. It's actually strong enough to hold things in it like clamps and other additives or decorative things that we put in our hair. And it's also another reason why braiding is so popular for curly and coily hair. So we're looking at the uncurling force and its contribution to the overall mechanical behavior of a piece of hair.
And what differences did you find in that among the different types of hair?
So interestingly, what we found, because traditionally it's been said that curly and coily hair is more fragile and tends to break more. And that we are seeing some of that, but also more than anything for hair that's considered pretty tightly coiled or curled, the uncurling force is extremely strong, along with everything else, including the force to hold the fiber together and really the whole profile in terms of the mechanical behavior of that hair compared to even some of the wavy examples that we had. So we see from that there's a lot more that we can investigate with that kind of hair.
Why was it important to do this research at Spelman?
So we wanted to do this at Spelman specifically for a couple reasons. One, I myself also have curly and coily hair, and I've always wondered how to answer this question. And then also our students, they all have curly and coily hair as well. We have students from all across the African diaspora, and also some from other ethnicities as well. And it's a question that's always been in their mind also. You wanna say anything about it, Amai?
Yes, definitely. I think Spelman College is the perfect place to start and to develop this project because we are an all-women HBCU, historically Black college and university. That means that every student here has been going on their own hair journey their whole lives. We all become experts in our hair and we all perform little experiments in our bathroom to see which hair type and which product works best for our hair type. Spelman is also a thriving community for Black female chemists, and what better project for them to work on than a project that they're passionate about because their whole life they've been working on it, like our hair research.
Thank you, Michelle and Imani, for sharing your research with us.
Yes, thank you for this opportunity. We've enjoyed talking with you.
Thank you so much.
Be sure to check out our other media briefings for ACS Spring 2023, which will be posted throughout the meeting at www.acs.org/ACS Spring 2023 briefings.